Good evening, roller derby fans. Welcome along to the Twitch WFTDA Twitch channel. I am Biff Mixalot. I am joined by Scotty Chicken and Kramer. And we're going to be doing a red-black intra-squad scrimmage for Rocky Mountain Roller Derby. And this game was recorded last week. We don't have any idea how this game turned out. Nobody's seen it yet. You're going to find out just like the rest of us. So we will we'll introduce our starting lineups. Scotty, if you want to dig in with Team Red.
I will. Team Red from the Rocky Mountain Roller Derby. Number 17, Mistress Terrible. Number 22 is Pound Cake. 49 is Tchaikilsky. Number 56, Orville Wreck. 98, Cherry Manilow. 394, Slitherjen. 406, Ruth Slater Ginsburg. 420 is Chi-Chi Chong. 511, Slady Blocken. 617, Harper Bazaar. 716, Slim Skatey. And 881 is Thomas the Pain, or T-Pain, depending on how you choose to pronounce that.
Okay, skating for Team Black, number 666, Acid Fuzz. Unfortunately, she was injured. Number 100, Bat-Ass. Number 52, Death Ray. Number 34, Derby Puckett. Number 1337, Jackie Lope. Number 626, Lilo and Stitches. Number 408, Postal Cervix. Number 89, Reign of Tarot. Number 234, Reverend Payne. Number 4, Ross. And number 16, Southern Discomfort. And we are underway. Looks like we have maybe a little bit of a false start.
A little bit of something, yeah. It's like, let's start and then, we'll just
let's stop. Hey, we're all shaking off the rust here.
Got to remember how these whistles work.
Yeah. Unfortunately, we don't have the two whistle starts anymore. But
oh, God. Yes.
Maybe somebody did. I don't know. Maybe somebody thought that still, but all right. All right. Jam number one is back underway. We have got number 49, Tchaikilsky, jamming for Team Red. And it's the Black Jammer, Team Black, getting lead.
That's Reign of Tarot.
That's Reign of Tarot.
Team Black. Yes.
She drew the right card. She's lead jammer. Scoring pass. Jam is called off. Tchaikilsky picks up a point, as does Reign of Tarot. 1-1. One jam in. 28-45 remaining in the first period of play.
Reign of Tarot drawing the one card. The one of points, I guess? Maybe this joke will make sense by the end of the bout as we workshop it a little bit more.
All right, looks like we've got number 234, Reverend Payne, to the jammer line for Team Black. And Team Red opting for the low contrast jerseys there. But Team Red gets lead jammer. That is Slim Skatey, the jammer for Team Red. Harper Bazaar drawing back, trying to create some space there for Slim Skatey. She is forced to the ref lay and has to retreat. Slim Skatey around the outside.
And picking up a cut track.
Yeah.
The old foot out of bounds trick. So had lead, lost it.
Okay, so we are going to have a full 2-minute jam. Reverend Payne on the power jam now for Team Black. Approaching the pack on a scoring pass. Bounces around in the pack. Shuffled to the inside by Harper Bazaar, number 617. And Reverend Payne gets through, completes a 4-point scoring pass. That'll put Team Black in the lead. Probably to Slim Skatey is expired. Slim Skatey bounces to the infield, careful to avoid another cut track penalty.
Yeah, super embarrassing to get two of those in one game. Or one jam, rather.
Well, yeah. It's not good for the production. But Reverend Payne has completed a second 4-point pass. Slim Skatey completes a scoring pass of her own. And the jam ends. An 8. Reverend Payne picking up a couple more points there. 9-5 on that jam. So 10-6 to Team Black.
I'd like to say it's some great work by the camera people on this one. They're keeping track of the action just right.
Looks like we got a brief official timeout.
And while they're having a brief official timeout, let's go ahead and talk about insurance. Because did you know that ramp and bowl skating is also covered by WFTDA insurance? Junior and bank track also. Now, you want to check out WFTDI.com to learn more about getting supplemental insurance that helps when you get hurt on skates. Terms and conditions apply, but visit WFTDI.com.
There's some quality whistle chat going on in the chat, both the pros and cons of electric whistles and also the fact that Fox 40 makes masks with whistle holders, and now I want to see that because I'm not picturing how this would look in my head. But
doesn't the whistle sort of counteract the point of a mask?
Maybe the whistle's inside the mask. That's why I'm like, I would like to see a picture of this. I did announce some volleyball, and they were using the electric whistle, which was great for volleyball because it's not really loud, but maybe not so great for certain venues.
Maybe it's a time for rest to play air horns.
All right, looks like all official matters have been resolved here. Death Ray wearing the Jammer Star for Team Black. And Death Ray powering around the outside. They are lead jammer for Team Black. Mistress Terrible stuck in the pack for Team Red. Death Ray approaching on a scoring pass. Max somewhat stalled there in the back straightaway. Death Ray taking a tumble to the outside of turn three there. Mistress Terrible around the outside. But Death Ray completes the scoring pass. That's 4 points to Team Black. Mistress Terrible drawn back by one of the Team Black jammers. And Death Ray approaches on a second scoring pass. They're forced once again to the outside. Mistress Terrible bounced into the ref lane once again. Drawn back by number 100, Batass. As Death Ray completes the second scoring pass. 8 points total on the jam now for Team Black. Jam continues. Death Ray spins to the outside, back to the inside, calls the jam. And that's 12 big roller derby points for Team Black. Score now stands 21-6.
Yeah, that's our second three pass jam, but the first one where they got all the points, all three runs. It's Team Black lead twice out of three, and also I believe our first successful star pass in that last jam, as Cherry Manilow picked up the star for Team Red.
Okay, Be Nasty jamming against Chai Kilski. Chai Kilski picking up lead status for Team Red. Approaches the pack with urgency, splits the black blockers at the rear, and through for 4 points for Team Red. Jam is called. That's a 4-0 jam for Team Red, and they are now in double digits. Score stands at 21-10 in favor of Team Black.
And right now, are you one of those people that likes to get every piece of information about your favorite sport? Then you need to sign up to WFTDA Inside the Track newsletter.
So Slim Skady jamming now for Team Red against Reverend Payne of Team Black. And Slim Skady around the outside, first jammer out, not lead. So some sort of minor non-penalty infraction incurred on the way through the pack there for Slim Skady. She is through. 4 points for Team Red. And the jam is called. 4-0 to Team Red.
Yeah, it looked like... Because Red Jammer was out first, but wasn't indicated as lead, and then later became lead. So I'm not sure what was what happened in that exchange. But when they called it off, they were pointing at him. So
the officials reconsidered, saw more evidence, and sorted
might
things
have been
out.
A late call.
Yeah. So jam is underway. Lilo and Stitch is jamming for Team Black against Harper Bizarre of Team Red. And Harper Bizarre is lead jammer. How bizarre. Harper Bizarre skips the apex, picks up 4 points, calls the jam. And all of a sudden, we only have a 3-point game. Team Red narrowing the gap, 21-18 with 21-19 left in the first period.
Yeah, Team Red going for the small gains and repeated lead. Three leads in a row, 3 4-point jams. Bang, you're back into it. Makes up for that 12-point jam they gave up in jam three.
And they basically equaled that at this point.
Exactly.
Slim Skady jamming against Reign of Terror of Team Black. And Reign of Terror is lead jammer for... Oh, wait. Bit of confusion among the jammer referees there. Reign of Terror is lead jammer for Team Black. Both jammers approaching the pack. Reign of Terror, first through, picks up 4 points. Calls the jam, 4-0 to Team Black. 2 points picked up there by Team Red. Score stands now at 25-20 in favor of Team Black.
And a big thanks to Frogmouth for providing some Tier 1 subscriptions inside the Twitch chat. Congratulations to all y'all that received one.
Reverend Payne with the Jammer Star for Team Black. Chai Kilski hits the right note. Lead Jammer for Team Red. Accelerates into the back stretch. Sets up shop there for Chai Kilski. She gets through. She bounces off Jackie Lope. Calls the jam. 3 points to Team Red. No points for Team Black. And all of a sudden, we have a 2-point game.
Chai Kilski now with lead 3 out of 4 jams. I'm sorry, 2 out of 3 jams.
Slim Skady jamming for Team Red against Lilo and Stitch as a Team Black. And Slim Skady around the outside, lead jammer for Team Red. Both jammers out, eligible to score points. Pack speeds up, try to make life difficult there for Slim Skady. She decides discretion's the better part of valor, calls the jam.
That is our first double scoreless jam of the game.
It almost feels like 2000.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, I don't know if there's a drinking game tie around no scoring in a jam. I know we've got the lead change thing, but...
Well, we have to ease our way back into the drinking games here. This is still intra-squad scrimmage.
All right.
Harper Bizarre, jamming for Team Red, picks up lead. Jamming against Reverend Payne of Team Black. And Reverend Payne completes her first pass. Harper Bizarre on a scoring run. One blocker to beat at the front. She does so. That's 4 points to Team Red. And we have a lead change. Again, we're not quite ready for the drinking game yet. Let's pace ourselves here.
It is important to hydrate.
Not with that attitude.
Exactly. It's a Friday night. What else are you doing? They're partying in Denver or in Rocky Mountain land.
I'm a CPA. I work 7 days a week this time of year.
That's a good point. All right.
I don't really have a Friday night right now.
Yeah, Kramer and I just have to, you know, double up for you. We'll cover. It's all right.
I appreciate that. Death Ray with the Jammer Star for Team Black against Tchaikilsky of Team Red. And Death Ray fires it up. They are through. Lead Jammer for Team Black. Tchaikilsky in hot pursuit. That gets organized. The entrance to turn three. Death Ray spins in, calls the jam. Did they get any points? Yes, they got one. And I think they're still trying to sort out if Tchaikilsky picked up any points. Apparently she did not. So we have a one-point bout. Timeout has been called.
For Death Ray, that was their they are perfect on lead jammer at this point. Two jams have jammed twice, had lead both times. They had that 12-point jam back in jam three, and then picking up 1 point here to edge it that much closer.
And also taking this moment to talk about the broadcasting your games. Now, if you're from a league that would like to stream, you could broadcast your games without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming. The remote studio, which we are now a part of, can get you games on a global audience with as little as a smartphone. No matter your location, your budget, get streaming with the remote studio. And just contact broadcast at quadmedia.tv and check out our Broadcasting for Beginners resources at WFTDA.tv.
You get people like, I'm in Seattle, Biff, where are you located?
I am just outside of Toledo, Ohio.
Ooh. And Kramer, where are you?
Over the Glass City.
You're in a cool-looking room. But
Heart of Texas in Austin.
There we go. See, you get people from across the country announcing your game, either recorded or otherwise. I do like with this recording, we knew the video was going to be good, so that was a nice touch.
Reign of Terror jamming for Team Black. Slim Skady the jam for Team Red.
A beautiful shoulder check there, knocking Slim Skady into the infield and forcing the recycle earlier.
So Slim Skady picks up lead. She ducked around Jackie Lope. Slim Skady on a scoring pass, in and out. Picking up a quick 4 points. With that, Team Red has retaken the lead. Slim Skady through again, another 4 points on a power jam. Reign of Terror in the penalty box. She drew the wrong card, apparently. Slim Skady through once again. A quick 3 scoring passes. That's the biggest jam of the game for Team Red. And that's another 4 points for Slim Skady.
Yeah, Red doing an excellent job of opening that outside lane and just letting Skady's like just having a nice easy pass through the pack today.
Yeah, there was a star pass on Team Black to Jackie Lope. Fortunately, it was not productive for Team Black, but Team Red now with their biggest lead of the game, 44-26.
Well, as we saw earlier with Team Red, you know, Black has no problem, can chip, or, you know, maybe they get another 12-point, 14-point jam and get closer quicker. We shall see.
Tchaikilsky, jam has begun. Tchaikilsky, the jam for Team Red against Reverend Payne. Back splits up. Tchaikilsky out first, lead jammer for Team Red.
And not a lot of Reverend blockers Payne on the track.
Yeah. Lost a few blockers, some penalties. Tchaikilsky first to enter the pack. She bounces off, bounces to the inside. Picks up 4 points. As does Reverend Payne. Jack sets up at the old pivot line. Reverend Payne into the pack. Tchaikilski initiating the jammer contact and calling the jam.
Interesting. No additional
points.
Yeah, I was going to say, it looks like Reverend Payne only got two on that jam, on that pass, and not four. That may be, I see a ref skating over. Maybe a, not sure if it's a score adjust or if it's a, or if that's penalty box chat.
Well, given the location of the penalty boxes, it could be either.
Exactly. Like, it's kind of right next to the
protector. Yeah, this doesn't appear to be the traditional derby track setup, but
that's all right. Hey, thanks, Johnny Pepper, for acknowledging my win last week. That was an entertaining game out of Santa Cruz with very little video. So
no evidence, huh?
No, there's oh, there's evidence. I'm sure it's on the WFTDA YouTube channel if you want to go watch a game where the video freezes every 5 seconds and then the scoreboard drops out. It was a good time.
Oh, boy.
Entertaining. All right, looks like they did bump that up to 4 points on black, so they're at 30 now, not 28.
So, Mistress Terrible jamming for Team Red against Death Ray of Team Black. And this is the first time Death Ray has not gotten lead jammer. Mistress Terrible with lead. Pack is stalled in the back straightaway. Mistress Terrible enters the pack, bounces to the ref lane, and calls the jam. Able to collect 2 points, though. And that'll give Team Red a 20-point lead with 12:35 left in the first period.
I will say one positive thing about the Rocky Mountain home teams is you don't have to say who's in what color because it's just right there in the team name.
Right.
No one's in the Twitch chat going, which shirt is Team Red wearing? Now, they'll throw it off next time. They'll switch jerseys and be Team Red and Black, and that'll throw everything off.
Okay, looks like we have a jam interrupted here.
There's a quick flash of red to the jam line and they're back again.
Yeah. Got some coach and referee chat going on.
Yeah. Coachina. Well, while we got a little, we also like to go ahead and let you know that all of our live games are published on YouTube a few days later after, you know, the initial bout. And if you're watching on YouTube, please hit the thumbs up button. Let us know that you like the show. Really helps the channel, allows us to keep you informed and give you more derby coverage.
Okay, no pack is declared off the jammer line. Lilo and Stitches jamming against Mistress Terrible of Team Red. And Lilo and Stitches is through. Lead jammer for Team Black. That's the first time in a few jams.
I'm thinking they're on a power jam. Yeah, exactly. Yep. I was going to say, I think Lilo and Stitches must have picked up a penalty at the end of the last jam and started off in the box.
So Lilo and Stitches is through with lead, picks up 4 points. Jammer penalty to Mistress Terrible has expired.
Yes. Sorry, I had that
back. Star pass. Yeah. Hey, we're all still shaking off the rust here. Don't.
There we go. I was looking at the screen. I'm like, oh, that's the name.
Yeah. So Lilo and Stitches on a scoring pass. That's 8 points now total for Lilo and Stitches. Now 12 points, a third scoring pass.
That is Chi-Chi Chong, number 420, with the star for Team Red.
And don't look now, but Team Black is within 4 points. Mm-hmm. A 16-point jam for Lilo and Stitches. And the scoring continues. 4 more points. That is makes us a 20-point jam for Team Black. Nice attempted apex skip there by Lilo and Stitches. She is reabsorbed into the pack and has to yield. And Lilo and Stitches is through. That's another 4 points, and we have a lead change.
That was a super casual spin on the inside.
I was thinking that.
That was a slow motion Instagram reel there.
Yeah, that was very relaxed. I'm going to put that on Boomerang, so it's just going back and forth.
Felt like it should be played with Stevie Nicks track, you know? Nice and mellow.
Yes. With a bottle of ocean spray in one hand.
Yes.
So a 20-4 jam for Team Black.
Oh, 28-4.
28-4.
Ooh, yeah.
I need to get my reading glasses out to read that scoreboard.
It was a little blurry for a second. I had to go back and go, wait, we were at 30 before. That is a huge, clearly biggest jam of the game. And apparently worthy of an official review.
Well, in place of official review, let's go ahead and have a quick reading here for a minute. Let you know that the WFTDA has published new COVID-19 safety guidelines to support leagues in returning to play. You can check them out at community.wftda.org. These guidelines are being updated frequently and in response to changing conditions and regional guidelines, so be sure to check. Because, folks, we all want to get back to doing what we're good at.
Well, I think,
except for those whistle masks. I don't know about those.
Right. Yes, thanks to somebody in our...
Those just looked wrong. I'm sorry.
...that posted a picture of that. Now I'm like, it's almost like that plague doctor mask, only a little more phallic. They should have shaped it that way. Just a big cone, a big beak nose. That would have been better. I should be in product development for the whistle companies.
You've missed your calling. You got to go for
yes,
it.
Yes, clearly. All right, official review has come to the close. We didn't get any word about what it was about, but nobody's in the box, so. And they appear to have lost it, so there we have it.
So Slim Skady picked up a jammer penalty on her way through the pack. That leaves Reverend Payne with the opportunity to earn lead and go on a power jam now for Team Black.
I was unaware that the announcer curse could span time, but apparently it does, because I said no one's in the box, and immediately the jammer got a penalty from last week.
Oh, you know, that still works after 2 years.
Clearly.
Reverend Payne through, picking up 4 points on the jam for Team Black. Pack sets up in turn four. Reverend Payne approaches. Finds her way around the red tripod, picking up another 4 points for Team Black. Penalty to Slim Skady is over. And that was an 8-0 jam for Team Black. They have now a 12-point lead, 66-54. And we have a timeout. Ooh, an official review. Requested by Team Red.
Wow, so the previous, it's got to be about the penalty, right? Like, jammer right out the chute picks up a penalty? Well, we will see if they retain or not. See the light. Oh, maybe the white must be... I thought they used their official review previously, but maybe I don't understand the scoreboard. It's been 2 years, as you've mentioned repeatedly. Kramer, what else we got on the promotional read fun?
Well, on the promotional read fun, we got a nice big one talking about WFTDA's hosting the Back on the Track Global Celebration of Roller Derby that's going to take place during September and October, celebrating the reemergence of the sport and showcasing all levels of play globally. Now, right now, they're looking for hosts for events during this time period and anyone to be included in the celebration. Events of all sizes, locations, levels of play are encouraged to apply. The host application is available and participating games and events will be announced monthly. Interested teams, officials, announcers, photographers, and other volunteers can submit these forms and be notified of events that they may be interested in participating in. So if you want some more information, you can go over to community.wftda.org/events/2022, folks. Please come out there, get involved. You're going to love it.
Right on. And speaking of getting involved, as if you watched the earlier game, that was a pay-to-play mashup with a bunch of skaters from around Colorado and Nebraska. And this is a fundraiser for the Rocky Mountain Roller Derby. If you want to donate, there is a little QR code down there in the corner. So just snap that with your phone and throw some cash to the Rocky Mountain folk.
And Jake Frepp in the chat, don't give him ideas about naming Team Black Red and Team Red Black. They'd do that to us.
All right, Shai Kilski. Team Red, the Team Red Jammer picks up lead against Death Ray of Team Black. Back organizes in turn two. Shai Kilski into the pack on a scoring pass. Calls the jam.
Squeaking out that one little point.
Yeah. Every little bit helps.
Yes.
Margin South now stands at 11 points, 66-55 in favor of Team Black. Irvin Payne jamming against Slim Skady. Red blockers set up at the front for Reverend Payne. Obstruct her path. But Slim Skady is through and lead jammer for Team Red. Scrum at the pivot line, occupying Reverend Payne. Slim Skady cruises on through, picks up 4 points.
Slim Skady nearly perfect as jammer. Only didn't have a lead in that last jam she jammed because of the penalty, but otherwise, put into jam, gets lead.
So Slim Skady in the pack on a second scoring run, has to retreat, calls the jam. Yet to be established how many points she was able to pick up on that second pass. Yeah, it was 3 more points, 66-62. So Red back within one full scoring pass.
You know, you got to hand it to these officials. It's been calling a solid game so far.
Lilo and Stitches, a workhorse in both games tonight. Jamming for Team Black. She is through. Lead jammer. Shai Kilski shuffled to the back of the pack. Has to fight way through a full core of black blockers. While Lilo and Stitches cruises through on a scoring pass. 4 points to Lilo and Stitches. Back advancing to the back straightaway. It's like we've had a star pass to Chi Chi Chong of Team Red. Lilo and Stitches through again, picking up another 4 points. Back splits in turns 3 and 4. Lilo and Stitches through again. That's another 4 points, another double-digit jam for Team Black. 78-62 now. Lilo and Stitches attempts the apex jump, retreats, re-enters, calls the jam. That's another 4 points. A 16-point jam for Team Black, and they now have a 20-point lead, 82-62.
And that has definitely been Team Black's MO this whole game. They've had 3 jams of 1 pass and scoring, and I don't think they were, well, they were leading a couple of those. Otherwise, it's been multi-pass, multi-points, or nothing. Sort of a feast or famine mode.
And that'll bring Death Ray, speaking of double-digit jams, back to the jammer line. They are through, lead jammer for Team Black. Harper Bazaar, the jammer for Team Red. She has been busy tonight as well. Death Ray calling the jam. score remains 82-62. 3:21 left in the first period. It's like Slim Skady back to the jammer line for Team Red. Reverend Payne, the jammer for Team Black. And, oh, that's number 34. Excuse me. That is Derby Puckett. Out and lead jammer for Team Black. This is her first turn with the jammer star. Derby Puckett around the outside. Picks up 4 points. Calls the jam. Team Black now with a 24-point lead on Team Red. 86-62.
Bobby Narco in the chat calling out the stat tracking and analysis. And Bobby, I would like, if you don't mind, typing into the chat some of the mathematics around the scores and the common denominators and factors. That would be excellent, since no one does that as well as Bobby.
Greatest common factors and least common denominators.
Yes.
Harper Bazaar back to the jammer line for Team Red against Reverend Payne. How bizarre, lead jammer for Team Red. Harper Bazaar hoping to cut into Team Red's lead, into the pack, on a scoring pass. Coming together with a couple of Team Black blockers. But she gets through, pops up, picks up 4 points, calls the jam. Back to a 20-point deficit now for Team Red, 86-66. Minute 30 left in the period. Possibly the last jam of the half. It's like Death Ray on the jammer line for Team Black against Chykilski. Chykilski has made the most forward progress, but not quite enough to beat Death Ray out of the pack. Death Ray, lead jammer for Team Black. Oh, wait. Or Chykilski is lead jammer, excuse me. Maybe a bit of confusion there.
Yeah, I was going to say that would be heartbreaking to be almost out and then just get past at the last second. Clearly push the pack far enough forward. Maneuver. Yes.
So the jam was called. That was a scoreless jam. Score remains 86-66. And we have less than a minute to play in the period. Slim Skady back to the jammer line for Team Red. And number 89, Reign of Terror, the jammer for Team Black. But Slim Skady out and lead. Chance to cut into the deficit before half. Slim Skady enters the pack, is leveled at the apex of turns one and two. Loses the jammer star in the process. Puts it back on. Reapplies the jammer. Yeah. Slim Skady forced a retreat. Re-entering on a scoring run. Ross Dress for Less, recipient of the star pass for Team Black. Slim Skady's picked up 4 points. Minute left in the jam. We are on jammer time now. Slim Skady threw for a second 4 points. 8 total on the jam for Team Red. Max stopped at the entrance of turn three. Slim Skady has to retreat. Whistles in the pack. Maybe some penalties to be dealt out. While Slim Skady completes a third scoring pass. That is a 12-point jam for Slim Skady. Ross Dress for Less finally liberates herself from the pack. Jam continues, less than 10 seconds now. Slim Skady into the pack, bounced by number 400. That is number 408, Postal Cervix. Our intermission interview, Postal Cervix, yes, with the key block there. What a 16-point jam for Slim Skady. Team Black's lead has been cut to single digits, 90-82 as we head into halftime.
Whew. That was it. I love when a good block happens right in front of the camera. And that was a beautiful cut off of the outside lane. Like, ah. Yeah,
perfect. It's, well executed.
Yes.
Yeah. Exactly. Well executed slam of the door on the jammer.
Yes, exactly. She's like, I got the open lane. No, you don't. I'm going to close that door for you. Well.
Man, nothing so, like an airborne jammer.
Exactly. That was a fun first half with a lot of... I'll have to do the totaling up, but I think Team Red had lead more often and had more jams where they scored points, but yet Team Black obviously more larger jams. So it's that again that sort of feast or famine, and that man, that 28 points, that really changes things around when you can jump from I'm a little behind to I'm 20 points in the lead.
Yes, it
can. They're really pressing it. I mean, yeah. you could see the skaters looking gassed inside the box toward the end of that half. They were throwing everything they could to stop those jammers.
Definitely. Hmm. All right, we're going to take a little break. You can click on the scan to donate. I'm pointing here as if you can see what I'm pointing at. It's the thing that says scan to donate to Rocky.
It's the QR code with the dinosaur in it. Yeah,
exactly.
Lower right of the screen.
Click that donate to Rocky Mountain, and we'll be back in, I don't know, 5 minutes. 10 minutes.
Sounds about right.
They'll tell us. Just leave it on. You know, you don't want to.
Just leave it on. Second. We'll be back. Don't worry about it.
Exactly.
We'll give you enough time to go to the fridge. Yeah.
Hello.
All right. How are we doing tonight? We're back. We're checking in on the Rocky Mountain Roller Derby Watch Party. I think we have B Nasty with us. So. Okay, B Nasty. Okay. We hear this is your first game as a skater for Rocky Mountain. How do you feel about it?
I was really nervous. I basically learned to skate like 4 months ago.
Okay. All right.
I was described as Bambi on ice and blue sparkly skates.
No, go ahead, Beth.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's how a lot of skaters get started. So what led you into joining Rocky Mountain Roller Derby?
My friend just sent me like, cause I got skates over COVID and was just skating outside. And I was like, I've always like wanted to join a roller derby team. And my friend sent me the recruitment thing. And I was like, I might as well show up. It said like, no skills necessary. And that they trained me. So I was like, all right, here I am. And that's how I started. Okay.
So how was the actual experience compared to how you imagined the experience would be of being in your first game?
I mean, it was like just as intimidating and scary as I thought it would be. Like, but I mean, it, like once I like shook off the nerves, it wasn't quite as bad. Yeah, Chai got some good hits in on me, and I took it. I didn't fall. I was so proud of that.
Nice.
Okay. I mean, the first time you jammed, how did you feel about that?
Well, I didn't realize that I like. With my name, I unintentionally made like the best chant for me. Like, so like, my friends were all like, let's get nasty.
So do you have a bunch of friends at this game?
Yeah, I had a little fan cheering section. It was nice.
Okay.
Awesome.
All right.
So you're looking forward to the next game, I hope, now that some of the nerves are done. Theoretically, be better. Yeah. Awesome. All right. Well, I think we should probably get back to it and watch the second half and see what other amazing things you do.
Yeah. Hey, thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
All right. Thanks, B Nasty. Thank you, Chai.
Yeah.
And just like that, we're back in the past. Dang. I like this having the watch party thing and then like jumping into exciting party action in the middle of the game.
Well, you have the party, and you have the skaters who have had a chance to reflect on what went on in this bout,
exactly,
and share whatever little nuggets of insight they can. And so we've got an 8-point game, start of the second period.
And again, click that, take a picture of that little QR code, donate to Rocky Mountain, and of course now you can't because it's off the screen, but or maybe it's
and Tchaikilsky is. Tchaikilsky is magically transformed back into a skater. Helmet pads and everything. First to take the Jammer Star for Team Red in the second period. Against Lilo and Stitches. Lilo and Stitches gets tripped up at the exit of the pack. One blocker to beat. And Lilo and Stitches is lead jammer for Team Black. Backdrops anchor in turn two. Tchaikilsky trying to get out. Lilo and Stitches on a scoring pass. Spins out of the pack. Picks up 4 points. And Tchaikilsky passes the Jammer Star to Harper Bizarre. While Lilo and Stitches attempting a second scoring run. One blocker to beat. She does so. That's another 4 points. Two full scoring passes for Team Black. Their leads back out to 12. Harper Bizarre picking up 4 points for Team Red. Pack stopped in turns three and four. Harper Bizarre hits the apex jump. Picks up a few more points, but Lilo and Stitches able to pick up a third scoring pass. 12 points total on the jam for Team Black. And they are first to 100 points. 102 to 90.
I liked the toss of what I'm assuming was the pivot helmet cover, which is still looks like it's on the other side of the track. So that should be fun for Team Red trying to rework into their rotation.
Slim Skady to jam against Reverend Payne, and Reverend Payne, first to the inside, lead jammer for Team Black. Team Black 2-for-2 on getting lead status in the half so far. Reverend Payne gets tripped up, calls off the jam. No points for either team.
The old off-camera collision and fall.
Yep, those tape left strikes to your can own be imagination. Pretty pesky.
Death Ray to jam against Mistress Terrible. Back moving glacially away from the jammer line. And Death Ray out of the pack. Lead jammer once again for Team Black. Mistress Terrible passing the Jammer Star. The recipient once again is Harper Bizarre. Death Ray through the pack, picks up 4 points, calls the jam. Harper Bizarre able to collect two.
And again, chucking the other helmet cover off. It's just too much weight. Don't want to be weighted down by a second cover.
Kind of wonder if it's a strategy just to keep it on that it won't stay on top of the doubled up.
Oh, that could be.
So we've got number 34, Derpy Puckett, jamming for Team Black against Slim Skady of Team Red. And somehow off camera, Slim Skady picks up lead jammer for Team Red.
I think Slim Skady picked up a penalty off camera.
Ah, okay. So
that was a starting to go, and then I think shifted into maybe a cut track, but...
Okay.
Shenanigans were bad.
So Derby Puckett on the power jam for Team Black. Pack sets up the apex at turns three and four. And Derby Puckett through the pack picks up 4 points. to repuck it around the outside on a second scoring pass. Penalty to Slim Skady has expired. Slim Skady retreats to the rear of the pack. She was recycled. Derby Puckett completing a second scoring pass off camera. And Slim Skady is through. 8-0 in the jam so far for Team Black. Blockers set up at the opening of turn three. Slim Skady is it through and able to collect 4 points. Derby Puckett reapproaches from the rear of the pack. Both jammers eligible to score points. Derby Puckett forced to the outside. And the jam ends. Derby Puckett able to collect yet another double-digit jam for Team Black, 12-4. And their lead now stands at 22 points, 118-96, 24-18 left in the game.
A heck of a forearm penalty coming out of that last part of that.
I'm assuming that was on the takedown of Slim Skady right at the end of the jam. Just got leveled.
So 4-on-3 in the pack in favor of Team Red. Reverend Payne jamming for Team Black against Harper Bazaar. And Harper Bazaar breaks up the tripod at the rear of the pack. Finds her way around the outside. But is not lead jammer. That goes to Reverend Payne. Reverend Payne with Harper Bazaar in hot pursuit as the blockers advance to turns 3 and 4.
Team Black now perfect in lead jammer for this half.
Team Red able to steal a point on that jam. But Team Black also able to score, so the score stands at 119-97. Death Ray returning to the jammer line for Team Black against Chai Kilski of Team Red. Chai Kilski pushing the blocking sled out, gets around the outside, and is lead jammer for Team Red.
First lead of the half for Team Red.
Chai Kilski approaching the pack with some urgency. On a scoring pass. Bounces around as Death Ray approaches. And Death Ray is through. Oh, that star has been passed to Reign of Tarot. Excuse me. Reign of Tarot has picked up 4 points. Chai Kilski has completed her first scoring pass. Pack locked up in turn 3. Chai Kilski into the pack. Through once again, calls the jam. And we'll see how many additional points are assessed. That's 3 more for Chai Kilski.
Had to love Reign of Tarot's reaction after getting knocked out of bounds and just slamming the hand into the ground. Like, how dare you knock me out? I had the open lane.
Well, the deck was stacked against her.
Ah, yes.
All in all, a 7-7 jam. Score gap remains at 22 points, 126-104. 21-27 left in the game. Slim Skady to jam against Derby Puckett. Slim Skady sheds a blocker.
Ooh.
Both jammers locked up in the pack as they approach the pivot line. Slim Skady has to retreat behind number 1337, Jackie Lope. Derby Puckett getting hemmed in by number 406, Ruth Slater Ginsburg.
And another cat track for Slim Skatey. So power jam for Team Black.
Power jam, if Derby Puckett can find a seam in the pack, she has to recycle to the inside of turn one. And Derby Puckett is through. She has completed her initial pass, not lead jammer. So we're looking at possibly a full two-minute jam. Pack is stalled in the back straightaway. Penalty to Slim Skatey has expired. Derby Puckett drawn back to turn two. Slim Skatey crowbars her way through the pack. She is not lead. Points yet to be scored by Derby Puckett. Slim Skatey on us is now eligible to score points. She encounters a tripod of black blockers at the front. Slim Skatey. And the jam has timed out. Derby Puckett picking up 2 points for Team Black. And we'll see how many for Slim Skatey, if any.
It was a lot of work for not a lot of points.
Just I mean, a lot of skating, but maybe just not a lot of, you know, just forward and backward. You know, skaters, jammers trying to recycle. It's like we have the officials conferring, probably over points.
All right.
And Slim Skatey picks up 2 as well. 128-106 in favor of Team Black. Reign of Terror, the jammer for Team Black against Mistress Terrible. Reign of Terror with an escort from number 100, Batass, gets out of the pack. Lead jammer for Team Black. Mistress Terrible recycled behind the jammer line, off camera. Don't know quite know how. As Reign of Terror on a scoring pass. Escapes the clutches of the pack, picks up 4 points.
Some great work keeping the feet inbounds. Just constant pressure to the inside. Not letting him knock her out.
Mistress Terrible still bottled up at the rear of the pack, yet to complete her initial pass. Reign of Terror on a second scoring run now.
And star pass complete for Team Red. Handed off to Cherry Manilow.
Reign of Terror completes a second scoring pass.
Nice. Looked like fortune was in her favor. She got a good reading off of it.
So Black's lead extended to 136-106.
Please note, Bobby Narco is now providing us with some scoring facts in the chat. Probably doesn't apply now, but he did say earlier that it was almost a 5-4 scoring ratio with 26 as the common denominator.
That's some fine number crunching.
So if he can find the common denominator between 234 and 617, Harper Bazaar and Reverend Payne's numbers, that would be appreciated. Harper Bazaar picks up lead, maybe. She loses the jammer star. Maybe we have no lead jammer. Harper Bazaar through the pack, not lead.
Yeah, I think Reverend Payne hasn't come out yet, right? There we go.
Yeah, there we go. So Reverend Payne with lead jammer status. Harper Bazaar completes a scoring run. So Black Hat lead scored no points. May the Derby gods have mercy on their soul. And Team Red has closed the gap to 136 to 110. 16:01 left in the game. We are in an official timeout from the looks of things.
In the meanwhile, sorry, go ahead, Kramer. You've got points to read. I was going to say that in the chat, I like that Jackie Lope is saying that she sat on the helmet cover. Perfectly accidentally.
Of course.
Of course. No always strategy involved at all.
Never, never.
A big
There's
shout
no gamesmanship in Derby, come on.
Never.
A quick shout out to Frogmouth, who's partnered with WFTDA to support the COVID Recovery Fund. 10% of all sales from their products for their special The Pack is Back WFTDA Return to Play collection will be donated to the Recovery Fund to help the WFTDA community members recover from the COVID pandemic. Visit their online store at frogmouthclothing.com. And it seems the refs are content to pirouette during this timeout.
And
yes. Go ahead.
Tonight I learned that 617 is a prime number.
Right.
Oh, I'm sorry, Scotty.
I was going to say the exact same thing. I'm like, Bobby's pointing out 617, no common denominators, it's prime.
Dang.
Speaking of prime,
if
you've got an Amazon Prime account, you can subscribe for free on Twitch. Thus tying.
Now that is Bobby a segue. Narco.
Yes. We like to keep those things smooth and almost legit.
And smooth and legit, Death Ray, lead jammer for Team Black. Slim Skady out in hot pursuit.
She's killing it.
So Death Ray passes a skater, calls the jam. See how many points they were able to pick up one. So it's 137 to 114, 15:18 left in the bow. Ross dressed for less, jamming for Team Black. Harper Bazaar, the jammer for Team Red.
The seldom
they are
seen
both enjoying the selections
defense.
Of the DJ. Yeah. Jam is underway. Harper Bazaar has to retreat. And Harper Bazaar is through. Lead jammer for Team Red. Star has been passed by Team Black to Reign of Tarot. Harper Bazaar in a scoring run. And calls the jam, discretion being the better part of valor. And 3 points to Harper Bazaar. We now have a 20-point game. 137-117 with 13:54 left in the game. Crouching blockers, hidden jammers on the screen. It'll be Slim Skady against Lilo and Stitches to the jammer line. Both jammers out at approximately the same time. And it's Lilo and Stitches with lead status for Team Black. Blockers accelerating away through turns three and four. Lilo and Stitches skips the apex, calls the jam.
That was an aggressive call-off.
But one point for Team Red. See if Black got any points out of that. Two points for Team Red.
Good call out in the chat from Quantum Mechanic. Holy God's death ray is fast. To which Chai replies, they are. And I would agree. They are super fast.
So the aggressive call off by Lilo and Stitches doesn't quite pay off from the looks of things.
Well, it looks like they're motioning
to the bench.
We saw
a timeout.
Yeah, it looks like it's okay.
Okay.
Team Red, speaking of aggression, going with a two-jammer rotation for the last five jams.
Yep. Harper Bazaar back out for Team Red. Reverend Payne the jammer for Team Black. Harper Bazaar is lead. Into the pack, calls the jam. Only
they're
1 point for Team Red.
Yeah, they're going to crawl back 1 point at a time.
Well, if they can get 19 more jams in 12 minutes, that might work.
Never all right.
Well, we have a team timeout.
And with the team timeout means a nice little announcement of different things on our announcer read sheet, including
yes.
Following us on Twitch to be notified every time we go live. Remember, once again, bringing Prime back into it. If you have the Prime account, you'll be seeing no ads with your free, you know, it's going to be with your Prime subscription. No ads, no bother, no nothing. Asking Chad if you need help linking to your account. Also, did you know that ramp and bowl skating is covered by WFTDA insurance, as well as junior and bank track? I mean, don't take any chances. Make sure to check out WFTDI.com to learn more about getting supplemental insurance that helps you when you get hurt on your skates. Terms and conditions may apply, but please visit WFTDI.com, guys.
Always good to have that little extra bonus insurance just in case.
Oh, yeah.
Just in case.
Yes. I do not have WFTDA insurance. They would not have helped me with my slipping on the stairs. But if I'd been on skates, maybe. I don't know. Is stair slipping down skating covered by the WFTDA insurance? Probably not.
They won't cover the bowls that I deal with anyway, so that's fine.
would they cover like an announcer falling off the dais at a tournament? That's what I want to know.
Oh, If you had the insurance, very possibly. I don't know.
And they would argue why the announcer wasn't wearing safety gear.
It's true. Yes.
I mean,
I don't usually wear elbow pads and wrist guards.
Yeah. A helmet would be decorative for an announcer's purposes, but
or advisable in a contentious interview.
Let's go to the losing team locker room. Yeah.
Yes. Back to the chat, Bobby Narco pointing out that we are closing in on 12 squared versus 11 squared in the scoreboard.
Yes, Quantum Mechanic. Yes, Quantum Mechanic, if you're just clumsy, yes, you can get insurance.
This team timeout is extensive. Or maybe it just feels that way.
Oh, jump cut.
This might be. Ooh. Come on, Bobby. We want to know if they are. Not if they might be Prime. And we're back.
Slim Skady back to the jammer line for Team Red against Lilo and Stitches. And Lilo and Stitches finds a seam around the outside. Opens it up, lead jammer for Team Black. Slim Skady in hot pursuit. Jammer contact initiated by Lilo and Stitches. Into the pack, calls the jam. And doesn't look like he had any points for either team. Score remains 137-119.
Yeah, Team Black playing it smart. Call off the jam, burn 30 seconds off the clock. Still in the lead. Time is on their side.
That's a lot of clock to burn, though.
True.
And they're sending their best jammer, one of their best jammers, Death Ray, to the jammer line against Harper Bazaar. Harper Bazaar one beats Derby Puckett through lead jammer for Team Red. Death Ray sets off in hot pursuit. Blockers advancing out of turn two. Harper Bazaar on a scoring pass. Cruises through the middle of the pack, picks up 4 points, calls the jam. Team Red beginning their inexorable comeback, down 137 to 123.
It all starts with one step right there.
1 point at a time, one skate in front of the other. Team Red starting with a 4-on-3 pack advantage. Slim Skatey against Reverend Payne. Reverend Payne, blessed with lead jammer status, 14 black. Slim Skatey has to recycle. Trying to get out as Reverend Payne approaches. Chykilski sending Reverend Payne to the infield to delay her progress. Jam is called.
And yes, TC Screamer, you're right. Announcers as a whole are uncoverable by insurance. We are a high-risk group.
Some excellent defense in that last jam by Team Black with the just water falling forward and keeping Slim Skatey back in the pack and slowing down the progress. Picked up 2 points. Again, stretching the lead a little bit, and once again, burning more clock.
Reign of Terror to jam now against Harper Bazaar. Jam is underway. Reign of Terror through and lead jammer for Team Black.
Black has had lead in all but four jams in this half, and that is definitely helping them keep this lead.
No, they're winning the war in the trenches.
Yes.
So to speak. And Reign of Terror picks up 3, calls the jam, 142 to 123 now. Team Red passed 11 squared, according to the math of Bobby Narco. So we will reset. Team Black, a 19-point lead, 8:17 left in the game. Death Ray to jam against Slim Skatey. And Death Ray fires up the lasers out of the pack. Lead jammer for Team Black.
When half the team falls down in front of you, easier to get through the pack.
Well, Death Ray was set to vaporize, I think.
Yes.
On the red pack. Death Ray, they have picked up 4 points. They are in the process of picking up another 4. And Death Ray will call the jam. 8 points for Team Black.
It looks like we're going to take a knee for a red skater who has a little trouble getting back up around turn two.
Yes, I think that was Chykilski taking a little hip check to the ribs. Ooh. Meanwhile, Bluebeard pointing out that 7 times 17 is 119. I wasn't following the full math conversation in the chat, but there was plenty of it. Meanwhile, jumping ahead in time, back to game.
All right, Team Red picking up lead status. I believe that is Harper Bazaar with the jammer star. Back at a standstill at the apex of turn two, Harper Bazaar through, picking up 4 points. Our halftime interviewee, I think, is in the penalty box. And I'll put Harper Bazaar on the power jam. So Red with a chance to take a chunk out of Team Black's lead with under 7 minutes remaining in the game. Harper Bazaar gets recycled to turn two. Pack reestablishes in the back straightaway. And penalty to Be Nasty has expired. So skaters locked up in turn three.
And I think we've got Harper Bazaar now in the penalty box. I think I see a helmet sitting in the red jammer seat.
Yeah. So that'll put Be Nasty. This might be the first power jam of her career.
Yes.
Ooh.
Oh, and Be Nasty tackled at the jammer line, bounces up, shrugs off another, almost shrugs off another block.
Like the coaching going, no, go that way. You don't have to go back. Fell down.
She's getting lots of instruction from the bench there.
Almost expected the medics to join in.
So Be Nasty on the power jam. Yeah. This will be a full two-minute jam, neither jammer with lead status. Harper Bazaar's penalty is done. And Harper Bazaar is through. Twelve to eight on the jam so far, and that's the way it'll end. Team Red narrowing the gap to 156 to 135. 5 minutes left in the game.
Jack Gilski's saying that both teams were yelling at Nasty to go.
Nice.
Gotta love sportsmanship.
Oh, it's a late timeout.
We have a jam interrupted leading into a timeout.
Yes. Team timeout, which will... this will play well to Team Red, because again, they have been going with the same two jammers for the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 jams counting this one.
Whoa.
Just back and forth between Slim Skady and Harper Bazaar, which is, I'm assuming, because their numbers are reversed, right? 7, 16, and 6, 17. It's just like, it's easier to keep it, just flip the 6 and the 7 back and forth, leave the 1. Kramer, anything else on the wondrous read sheet that we need to share with the folk?
Well, it's funny you should ask, because most of you have seen the beginning skater program. This is Roller Derby. Now, if you have questions about where and how to start, make sure you join the Skating Education and Training Community at WEFTDA. We'll be discussing your questions, adding resources, and linking to more information about the skating curriculum. Skating Education and Training at community.wftda.org.
And again, a little confusion over, is that a rolling whistle or just a really long whistle?
So we've got Reverend Payne jamming now against Slim Skady for Team Red. And Slim Skady gets through, lead jammer for Team Red. Skady cuts to the inside, forced to the infield, has to retreat, has to recycle.
Oh,
Slim Skady eludes Reign of Tarot, collects 4 points for Team Red. Reverend Payne approaching now on a scoring pass, as is Slim Skady. Back locked up at turn two. Slim Skady forced to the referee lane. Has to retreat all the way to the apex of turns one and two. Reverend Payne recycled as well. Slim Skady is through. That's 8 points for Team Red. But Reverend Payne completes a scoring pass of her own as Slim Skady picks up a third scoring run. She will call the jam 12-4 in favor of Team Red. 13 points the margin with 3 minutes to play.
Our Red's making a fight of it.
Slowly but surely, chipping away.
But so's that clock ticking away.
Yes, indeed. Getting some love in the chat for Ginger Spice, the referee in the teal helmet, which I got to say, I like the concept of the ref wearing the kind of poofy ruffled skirt. A nice throwback to early derby days.
This feels like early derby days for some reason.
It does.
Lilo and Stitches picking up lead jammer for Team Black. Speaking of poofy skirts, Lilo and Stitches around the outside through, picks up 4 points. Bumps the margin back out to 17. Harper Bazaar, the jammer for Team Red, now on a scoring pass. And Lilo and Stitches back to the inside, picks up another 4 points. Harper Bazaar, forced to the infield, has to recycle. Harper Bazaar pushing through a tripod at the front of the pack. But Lilo and Stitches has busily collected 12 points for Team Black. And Lilo and Stitches might be in the process of sewing up the game for Team Black.
Ooh.
Picks up 3 more points, calls the jam, 15-4 in favor of Team Black. That's a 24-point lead with a minute and a half remaining.
I liked the almost showboaty call off of that jam. Like, coming in, arms are up, like, you know what's coming. You know I'm going to call it off. And turn around and bam. That was a thing of beauty.
It just goes with the tutu, you know?
Yes.
It's exactly. Showy. Slim Skatey around the outside, lead jammer for Team Red. Death Ray, the jammer for Team Black. They are out in hot pursuit. Slim Skatey doesn't quite complete the outside scoring pass. She will call the jam. Was she able to keep Death Ray off the scoreboard? No, she was not. Timeout to Team Black with 34 seconds left in the game. So Team Black up by 178 to 151.
And after the balance, we will have an interview.
Yes, I was just going to say, thank you, Kramer. I'm like, we won't get team high fives, unfortunately. You can't do that on Twitch, but we will at least get to go back to the is it the week long after party, week later after party, the Rocky Mountain watch party, and have an interview, I believe, with Death Ray coming up. So that was good that Death Ray they were jamming in that last jam. And again, we've got our little QR code there. Please scan and help donate to Rocky so they can keep going as a league. Everybody's struggling to get back to Derby, and we want to help them out if we can.
Well, I appreciate Wilhelm Scream's contribution on the scoring ratio in the chat. Unfortunately, this is a intra-squad game. It doesn't count for ranking points. Lilo and Stitches jamming against Harper Bazaar. Harper Bazaar is lead jammer. This is the final throw of the dice. Ooh. For Team Red. Down 178-152, and Harper Bazaar is around and through for a scoring pass. 4 quick points for Team Red. Lilo and Stitches still on her initial pass. Harper Bazaar, a couple of apex skips. That's 4 more points for Team Red.
Well-executed double hop. It's all jam time now, right?
Nice.
Yes, we are on jammer time right now. Harper Bazaar with lead in control of the jam. She's completed 3 scoring passes, 12-4 in favor of Team Red. Penalty to Team Black, it looks like. One of the blockers. Harper Bizarre threw again on a fourth scoring pass. 45 seconds left on the jam clock. Lilo and Stitches has completed a second scoring pass, 8 points for Team Black. Harper Bizarre completes a fifth scoring pass. 20-8.
Oh, friendly fire.
Yes. And that's Harper's like, that's
enough. With the attempted apex jump. And I think that will end the game. A valiant effort by Team Red on the last jam, picking up 20 points to 9 for Team Black. But Team Black will prevail by a score of 187 to 172.
And no shade on Harper Bizarre in that last one, calling off the jam. The last 15 jams split not evenly between Harper Bizarre and Slim Skady, with Harper Bizarre getting 8 of the 15. So I would have called the jam off like from the start, because I'm not in any kind of shape. But that was a fun little run.
Yeah.
Oh, they went down swinging. They didn't go quietly. That's good.
Not at all. Both teams. I mean, from those big leads and both sides creeping back and getting back close and then pulling ahead. Good times.
Yeah. Both teams had their moments. I mean, they both had some double-digit jams. This was just a good, close, competitive game. I mean, Team Black, had control and led much of the second half, but you never had the feeling that Team Red was ever out of it.
Exactly.
It felt like a jammer war a lot. It's a lot of the same matchups that were going head-to-head.
I like that it appears that both teams are waiting for the other team to go around. They were both like, no, wait, we want the high five.
No, you go first, yeah. After you, we insist.
All right. Looks like we have our interview ready. So let's cut over to the present day and away from this recording.
Oh, here we go.
And talk to
Chai.
Here
we go, right here from Team Blank. Death Ray.
What a great bout, Death Ray.
Speak up, guys.
Yep. So
finger.
So go ahead, Scotty.
No, I had no question. I was just reacting to Chai's finger. I'm like, oh my God, she's poking me in the nose. What's happening?
Okay. Okay, Death Ray, looks like you had a really good game. Did you have fun? Was it nice to get back out and play again?
It was so much fun, yeah. And I love jamming, so like I've been blocking with Rocky a lot, and I think like getting just jam the whole game was like so much fun. No, I know, I'm a jammer, yeah. Nobody lets me have that identity, but now I think like I hope that from this game people are like, oh, Ray's a jammer. Yeah, great. Yeah.
I think you can safely
Everybody
claim
can be
that.
A jammer.
Yes. Yeah, and you were getting some good love on the Twitch chat from people commenting on your speed.
Which is wild because I'm not a fast skater compared to fast skaters, and so it was really heartwarming to see somebody call me fast. I was like, oh, thank you.
Hey, Derby's gonna love what Derby's gonna love.
Exactly. Right.
And everybody's hungry for it now, so. We're eager to get to do the outpouring of love.
Yes. So how's the party going?
So much fun. I'm about to get a tattoo. It's going to be great.
Oh.
It's a bat with skates. I don't know.
It's a bat with skates?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're going to be the fourth tattoo that's been done? Or the fifth?
Yeah, I don't know.
The fifth tattoo that's been done at this party.
Yeah. The old school.
Holy smokes.
If you have some more questions, we can totally do a Rocky cheer for you.
Yes. I have more questions.
Rocky
you
cheer?
Guys, I think we need the Rocky cheer.
All right. Hey, everybody. Put your pants on. On three, ready? 1, 2, 3. Rocky, Rocky, Rocky! Fight, fight, fight!
Well done. I like the.
Anyway,
someone just said, Chai's left the room. You can take your pants off. Is that what I heard? Okay.
Yeah.
That's good. Just wanted to make sure.
It's like 2009 all over again.
But it's been really fun. Thank you guys for being here, for making me not have to call these games that I called last week.
Thanks for making this all possible.
Exactly. I was going to say, happy to be able to join in your fun and let you go to the party, because if anyone deserves to party, it's you. You had to play and call.
I called the first one and I played the second one. No thanks. But anyway, next game, April 23rd. You know, keep your eyes up. Be on Twitch for that. And y'all have a great night, okay?
All right. Thank you. You too.
Thanks, Jai.
Have fun. Be safe.
I will.
All right. So I will say, between now and the April 23rd Rocky game that she mentioned, we may have some more remote studio action coming up on April 2nd, possibly from the California Derby Galaxy games. I'm hearing maybe there might be something overseas as well. And Kramer, you've got the info on if people want to stream their games, right?
That's right. If you want to broadcast your games. I'm looking over here, and I will bring it over here so it looks like I'm making eye contact in this illusion. You can broadcast your games without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming. A remote studio can get your games to a global audience with as little as a smartphone. No matter your location, budget, you can get streaming with the remote studio. You saw it here with the Rocky Mountain. They had their phone, and they were streaming from their home party. You can contact broadcast at quadmedia.tv and check out our broadcasting for beginners resources at WFTDA.tv.
All right. And as always, subscribe to the Twitch channel so you keep getting reminded of the games. And if you're watching on YouTube, like and subscribe there as well.
Absolutely.
All right. For Scotty Chicken and for Kramer, I'm Biff Mixalot. Have a good night, everybody.